run out of glue. Last one. Oh, here it comes, look. Oh, yeah. Nice. Happy with that. Can get on with the nerf right now. So we're ready for this final newel and this final little bit of wall string. You can see how it's all going to work now. Pretty much, as I said, exactly the same as what we did with this newel. We'll just take a measurement from the top of this tread down to the floor, mark it on that newel and cut that. What we've got to do is a couple of things here we've got to be really careful of. We need to make sure, obviously, again, that the shoulders of this this tenon on this string are upright. What we need to watch out for here, we've now got an additional bit of extra weight here, which is obviously, you could cut a prop under there if you wanted to. It's not that heavy, but if this was any longer, it runs the risk this weight will basically push that newel over there. So we just need, as I said before, we need to keep an eye on making sure that everything, when we're measuring, everything stays plumb, because obviously if that drops, if that leans over that way because of that weight, that'll drop and then we'll cut that newel and it'll be short. Doesn't matter, because we could pack it up. And again, I know I said we had to raise this hole up 10 mil, so unfortunately, yes, we are going to have to put some more, not those plastic packers, obviously, we'll put some more solid slate or solid packer under there. But yeah, just keep an eye when you're taking these measurements, we just need to make sure everything stays plumb. So take that measurement now, get that newel on, we can get that wall string in, and then I think it's yeah, we've got a bullnose there, we've just got to make sure that fits. So yeah, we have got it on the run now, as in terms of the sort of the main structure of the stairs. Right, so that's not long enough to worry, so that's going to go straight on there, isn't it? So they didn't leave that newel quite long enough, so that's going to have a packer under it anyway, so we haven't got to cut that. Same again. Not enough meat on the inside here to put a draw dowel in, so I'm going to have to face fix it through, which I do not like doing, but I'll counterbore the for the heads of the screws, and then we can put pellets over those with no problems. Get the handrail in, mark the draw dowels on those so we don't forget to put that in. That can go in. Where's the handrail? It's here somewhere, there it is. Right, so just going to quickly explain how I do my draw doweling. Obviously, you can see here, this is the hole that I marked through from the newel, and what we're basically going to do is going to offset the hole that we put for the draw dowel to go in, and we want it to be closer to the shoulder here of this tenon on this handrail. So what I basically do is put that on the edge, look, on the edge of the hole, and that gives me, not the sharpest bit, but that gives me, it's not even half a hole, but that gives me just enough shoulder for the dowel to pull that in. And then when the dowel will basically hit, as you can see here, look, the dowel's going to want to hit that point, and as it hits that point, it's going to be pushing it that way, which basically closes the gap between this shoulder here and the tenon. Beautiful. Excellent. So yeah, we're keeping everything, keep an eye on everything, make sure everything's nice and plumb. I think that's plumb. I just have to adjust that over a little bit to make sure that that's plumb look. So we know we're in pretty good shape, what we've got here. So maybe a tiny bit low on that side, but again, as I said, we really want to make sure we keep these newels nice and upright. We can tickle around with that backside, but we'll get this bottom, get this next wool string on, and then the last thing to sort of put in that's got two fixed points to work to is spinning round that bottom bullnose over there. Once that's in and we're happy with that sort of level, and you know, level along its width and along its length, we can start working from the bottom putting these kites in. I've got this last little wall string laid in. Obviously you can see that's just sitting nicely down. It's really important to make sure that, and I know that the way they've manufactured this, look, obviously these sort of two halves of this joint butt together, but sometimes there's a bit of play. You need to make sure, especially when you're sort of leveling things out, that these two top the housings for the top of the tread are flush. So what I'm looking at doing here really is I'm not too worried about putting a level across it this way, because these all read quite nicely. What we've basically got to do here, we know that this newel here is in the right place. So therefore, this is the top on this newel, this is the top tread of the bullnose. So basically what I'm looking to do really, I've just chucked some bits of block and stuff down there. What I'm realistically looking to do here, look, just see is roughly, look, can I hold it and doing it one-handed, look. Basically what I'm looking to do, look, is get the top tread, the tread of that bullnose level across there. So look, that's not bad. So we know we're sort of somewhere near. So what we can do now, pretty much exactly the same in this corner here, as we did in that corner, put a little tab on it, get it all glued up, and then we can just take the measurement. We know what size the bullnose is, we can check the measurement between the bottom of the housing here and the side of the riser housing there to make sure that that corresponds with the bullnose over there, and then we know that bullnose is going to go in. So yeah, got on the run now. I've got this last little wall string fixed in now, just got to make sure, see if this bullnose tread fits, which I'm pretty sure it will. Just sort of offer it into position. It's all a little bit flexible, obviously. Look at that. Yeah. So we know that, we know that's going to fit. So just a little bit, you know, if this building was slightly out of square, you might end up with a sort of pinch point here. But again, as I said sort of earlier, up above there, right at the top there, we've got 30 mil movement all the way around here. So once this whole set of stairs here, once this whole set of stairs is all sort of glued and clamped to itself, if we need to, we can adjust the whole thing around before we put packers and stuff behind the strings and fix it to the block work. Yeah, happy with that. Slight change of plan, just because it's going to be easier, I've just quickly unscrewed this wall string. The glue's still plenty wet, and I'm actually going to fix this bottom ball nose with kite on it. I'm going to fix it on there before I put the whole lot in, because it saves me getting right down on the floor there. So yeah, I'm just going to take advantage of being able to take it off and knock those two wedges in nice and easily. It saves me one less thing I've got to fix while rolling around on the floor there. Down tight, which it is. Lovely. That's it. Right. So another thing we're going to have to do, I just quickly just had a quick look, is we're going to have to slide in this kite, because otherwise we won't get it in because of the way that this it wraps around this housing here. So all I'm going to do is basically sort of offer it in there, and then when we slide this flight back in, it will slide over it, and then we can just sort of glue it up afterwards. So there you see, I've just sort of roughly slid it in. It's not fixed or anything, but now we can just slide this other one sort of straight over it. So yeah, glad I took that out actually, because it doesn't matter. I've done it before. You just have to sort of cut a bit of the nosing off, but it's better if you don't. So let's get that in. Thank you.
right down in the dirt. Get in the dirt, tail boy. Horrible. Oh, dear, dear. No knees. Oh. Excellent. Right. Excellent. So what we'll do now is we'll just double check all the little margins around it before we put too much more in. I've cut a few bits of batten and stuff. It's looking for about 30mm, but sort of anywhere between 25 and 30. We don't know particularly how square this block work is, but we'll get the margin somewhere near. Let's see that better look.
We'll get the margins sort of somewhere near all the way round. And then we can start putting these kites in and the whole thing will be stiffened up. It's not too bad actually, that probably just wants to come out a little bit, but we can mooch it around here and there. Excellent.
Oh, down in the dirt. Oh. So, oh. Now it's just a simple case of me just cutting and checking that these risers fit, gluing them and screwing them in. Start at the bottom, obviously, because I don't want to get covered in glue if I start at the top and work my way down. Probably still going to get covered in glue anyway, but there we go. Oh, look at me, nearly 54, look at me. Still laying down in the dirt. Right, let's have a look here. Let me go there. Negative. Is it going to go? Yes. Plenty of glue. There we go. Brush. Right, treading here. Right. I won't film all of them because that'd be boring. I'll show you pretty much what it'll be. I'll show you at the top what I'm doing down here because it's always the same. So we're fairly simply just sort of fitting these kites as we go up. This one slides in nicely here, but as I hinted, nearly missed that kite. I think the second kite up, kite tread down at the bottom there. I couldn't get it in if I put the wall string on first. Well, unfortunately, I've taken them off the board a little bit here, and it's the same case up here. I'll show you a bit closer once I've got this simpler kite in. Basically what I'm going to have to do, it doesn't matter on stairs like this because obviously the MDF treads are going to be carpeted, but if they were solid oak treads, you know, I'd be in trouble. But having said that, if they were solid oak treads, I probably would have just engaged my brain a tiny bit more. So I'm going to get away with it in this instance. But let's get these, let's just sort straight in here like that and put a bit of glue on there, cut those wedges in there. Get that riser in, it's nice and simple. I'm working at sort of a better height now rather than down in the dust. So yeah, we'll get in there. Literally one step at a time, as they say.
So as I just explained, you can see here that because this kite tread has got this little return that goes around the housing in the newel post there, I'm not gonna be able to slide it in. It's this miscalculation on my part. What I should have done is exactly what I did down here. I should have just, before I slid this big main flight with the wall string up, what I should have done is just sort of hung it in there. But, you know, more haste, less speed perhaps. But again, it's not the end of the world because all I'm going to do, I'll just show you here, all I need to do there to get that in is just nip this, the front portion off here. I'll make a nice clean cut. And when I've got this tread in, I can just glue it back in. Again, it's not ideal and I should have picked it up, but it doesn't matter because these are all carpeted. If it was oak, it would be a different kettle of fish altogether. And like I said, maybe perhaps if I was doing an oak set of stairs, I'd perhaps just have my brain engaged 100% instead of 99%, but not a big deal. We'll cut that off and get this in.
Right. Stick a bit of glue on this.
obviously we put a lot more glue underneath. We put the wedge on, put a little bit of glue on here as well. You can just see here where I've just cut that little bit off, that little return off, but we can just glue that on afterwards. Just slide in now. Oh, nice. Excellent. Let's get a wedge cut up under there. Somewhere. That tread up into the housing until we get the riser on. Nice. I'll just quickly show you me putting this riser in here. Obviously these kites are in now and I've put the wedges in. And what I've done with this is obviously just take a measurement. They're all pretty much pre-cut anyway, these risers. To make sure I take a measurement from here out to here. And as you can see here, this is going to have a slight angle planed on the front of it, which is what I've done. You can see here, look. Where is it? Just planed that with my block plane. And try and do this one-handed. That's simply, look, we just push that up into position, look. Again, we slide it that way a little bit so we can now screw all that and put a wedge in that end. And then the most important thing really to make sure the stairs don't squeak is to put these, can you just see, I'm trying to point at them, these things. See these little glue blocks, we should make sure they're in, because that's the most common place that a stair will squeak is where the tread is joined to the riser, because that's where, you know, when you come down a set of stairs you sort of roll your foot over it. So making sure these glue blocks are on properly, make sure that, you know, that won't happen because the glue's super duper strong. Right, let's try and get this one in now. That's it. Boosh. That's all of it done. All I've got to do now, check it all for level, check the gaps against the wall, get some packers, fix it to the wall with frame fixings. Job done. As I've said many times before, using these frame fixings, these are fissure fixings, absolutely brilliant. Really good in all kinds of substrates. This is a brick, but what we've got there is silicone lightweight blocks, and these really do pull fantastically well. So that is what I'm using. I've obviously cut my packers in behind here.
I didn't show that because I'm not quite sure until we go through the magical process of editing. I'm not quite sure how long this video is going to be, so it might be 20 minutes long, it might be 50 minutes long. I don't know. If it has been long and you're still here, thanks for watching, thanks for hanging on. As I think I've said many times before, I use a drill to put these fixings in because you can just get more feeling in the fixing. Impact drivers are very powerful, and if you're not careful, you can sort of overwind these and strip them out, so you can feel the fixing, you know, how biting a lot better with these. Just a couple more and we're nearly done.
I just got one more little job to do, which is basically put a better packer under there. I don't know, I'll get some slate or something, you know, not these plastic packers, obviously. And obviously something, put a bit of DPC down there and a better packer there, because that is taking sort of all the load of that. But again, this has got the insulation screed to go on yet, so that will be wrapped with DPC as well. That is it. It's complete. Let's have a quick look at it. Everything's where it needs to be. Everything's nice and sort of plumb and upright. Everything's where it should be. It's looking good. So all fixed to the wall here. What I think is going to happen here is this is going to be, I'll just stand back a little bit. This is probably going to be a cupboard under there, and then there'll be a sort of wall through here. I think this is going to be a sort of dog's bed area. So I always like, if I can, encourage a customer to put some sort of physical prop down under a stairs. These fixings are really good, but you can't beat having it sitting on something like physical, like a stud wall. So hopefully that bit of stud work will go across here and that'll give that really good support there. Same down the bottom. What I'm going to do there is actually leave that prop in. I'm sure that's just all going to be boxed in. You won't see that again. It's guaranteed that that corner won't drop. So yeah, it's all fixed in. Let's have a little walk up at maiden voyage. Here we go. Oh, it's lovely. Solid. Look at that. Just get that packer out there. Oh, that should come out. I've just got to whip that packer out. That should come out. Oh, there we go. Yeah, brilliant. So let's have a look up here. Oh dear, unfortunately, we've got a bit of a gap here, because I think what's happened is this, not only were these out of level, these joists, but they also, they've lent back a little bit. So obviously I marked from the top and you can see, look. But anyway, it doesn't matter. They're not an awful lot. You've kind of got to hope for the best here, unless everyone's been super duper anal about setting out the block work. This wall has got to be dead square with these joists, because obviously this top tread is square to the string. So it's fairly square, but obviously we've got a little bit of a gap. It's not brilliant. Obviously, I'd rather it was tight, but what we can do is just cut a little fillet in there. I can put a few fixings now in through, probably just through this riser. Again, it's not really doing much. Basically, the sort of this gravity that's holding this stairs sort of down, if that makes sense. But we'll still put a few fixings in, and we could even put a few fixings down through the top of this nosing here, because obviously that's hard packed down onto, as we see here, look. It's hard packed down onto that packer. So yeah, that's absolutely brilliant. Really happy with that. So there we go. That's a good job done. That is a fairly decent margin all the way down for the dot and dabbers to get their plasterboard in behind. Feels really solid. This is it for the sort of first fixed part. I shan't do any more now until this wall's all dot and dabbed here. Then there's a half newel to go on here. I've done it in my other videos, you might see. Half newel to go on here, handrail to go through here, and then I can sort out, there's an apron piece, whether the customer will go for the apron that's been supplied or whether we'll just put a plasterboard return round, which looks nice and neat. But anyway, that's that. I really do enjoy doing stairs, and this is like a little sort of double kite winder set of stairs. Really quite enjoyable, really quite simple. The manufacturer that these stairs come from, I've fitted their stairs for 30 years, are absolutely brilliant, always spot on. The drawing's really accurate. The people that come out, the guys that come out and survey, do a really, really good job. They never overlook anything, and to be honest, even if they do, they're really, really good support. You know, they'll sort you out straight away. So, yep, that's me done now. I've just got to sort of tidy up this devastation. And then, I don't quite know exactly what the guys are going to want under there, but I'm sure if they want me to do it, they'll let me know. So there you go. I hope you've followed the video, and I hope you found it interesting. And if you have, thanks for watching.